This is a fish stair prototype that I made for the first marble machine.
Almost.
On the marble machine X, the fish stair will lift 2 rows of 8 marbles for every stroke. And I need a way to divide the marbles into nice rows of 8. And if you just let them divide them by themselves, as you can see, the marbles divide themselves into a honeycomb pattern. And I don't want that. I want 8 straight lines. And I have just an idea about how to achieve that with a very minimal amount of space and minimal amount of parts. Add washers because the thing sticks on the sides. I'm gonna add these. Okay, this is super promising. So, as expected, when it's just full and the 9th marbles come very quickly, you have this anomaly. It actually doesn't matter at all, because the fish there will eat and empty this up, and everyone will be happy.
Tack it! It's not tacky.
prototype is done, let's model the actual thing in Fusion 360. It's not really a tutorial, it's more that we talk so much about all the CAD work we're doing right now, so I thought I could let you in a little bit on an actual workflow this time. Create a new design. I'm gonna save this one as divide by 8. And the first thing you do is that you create a new component. This is the swing. Create a sketch. Usually I start with putting a marble in. A circle, 15.875. That's the dimension of one marble. Put in a constraint, we're gonna say that the marble is resting on this surface. So I can move it along that line. Let's also constrain it to the back of the wall. Like that. Now we've done a sketch in 2D, we're gonna extrude this shape into 3D. So I'm pressing E for extrude and I'm choosing my shape. And I'm gonna extrude this at exactly 8 marbles. And what's cool is that you can use equations. So I don't need to know how far 8 marbles is. I can just take 15.875, which is the length of one marble. And then I can say times 8. And this is the length of 8 marbles. I want this wall to be just shy of this last 8th marble. So we can edit this again. I can remove minus 4 millimeters. See how that looks? Yeah, this is something like it. Let's extrude the back wall 3 millimeters. That wall is going to take some beating over the years. Let's go back and edit that feature and instead choose 4 millimeters. So we're strengthening up this wall a little bit. I want to pilot drill some holes for the counterweight nuts on this plane. 11 millimeter cut. This top edge doesn't look too good. Let's redesign that. It's all the way. We have our swing. Now we need a way to secure the pivot point. And I want to be space efficient with this, so I don't want to put points on the outside. So we're cutting away this section because here we're going to hide a hinge. So a new component, base, 4. There we go. So that's the attachment holes where we can attach this base. I'm going to put some marbles in to show you the perspective. Let's go make some coffee. Cheers. Let's make the plywood base, shall we? 15.875. Should we learn parametric? I'm putting in the same value all the time. Marb, 15.875. Okay. User parameters. Okay. Marb. Yes. Now we can already use the parameters. This is the edge of the swing seen from above. I want to offset that by the distance of 5 marbles. So instead of putting a number in, I'm putting marb times 5. Genius! So we can multiply the word marbles, you know? Of course, we love that. So here you can see how the base fits perfectly into the plywood. And I have a 0.2 millimeter clearance slot. So there's our beautiful plywood ridges that will separate the marbles from each other. Cut this off at a 10 degree angle here. So now you can see that this slope has a 10 degree angle because that's how it's going to meet the fish stair. So this is what the STL file looks like. I emailed the STL files to Tobias and he can print them. And just slide them down here, so to there. And with that, I think the design is done for now. So we could just for fun tilt the marbles down by, we can pivot this thing on that point. So we tilt the swing like this. And the marbles then in turn will come rolling. will come rolling down. There will be more and more marbles stacking up here. Yep. So, every Wednesday we will add another part to the Marble Machine X. Right now we're doing a lot of design work in CAD, and I'm longing for the period where all of these designs are going to materialize, but we're gonna stick our head down, our neck down, and really keep on doing the CAD until all these things are solved, and then hopefully assemble the machine in a faster, more efficient way later. So, hope you enjoyed this, and thanks so much for watching. See you on the next Wintergatan Wednesday. Take care.